Launch of the Digital Sky Portal in 2018 marked the beginning of the operationalization of the CAR released by DGCA on drones in 2018 September.
Today, drones are seen as next IT in India. Having said that, it comes with a security threat. We should really appreciate the mission of Ministry of Civil Aviation and DGCA on this. They have introduced this first Digital Sky and NTNT concept. We are the first company created the RFO model for NTNT in a record-breaking time of 30 days.
Happiest Minds is very proud to have collaborated with the Ministry of Civil Aviation in the implementation of drone regulation in India. Digital Sky is poised to be the platform of national importance and has been entirely in India and for India.
So after compliant drones were made available by Indian OEMs in record time, the ball was in the service provider's court to register their drones and get a UIN. We, with support from the fantastic team at DGCA, were able to acquire India's first UIN number on a drone manufactured by our friends at Astute Aerospace.
There was constant concerns raised by the industry regarding existing legacy drone equipment. Ministry of Civil Aviation addressed these concerns and announced the program to register existing drones by issuing owner acknowledgement number and drone acknowledgement number. In the following days, multiple exemptions were granted to use these drones for emergency response.
With the first successful NTNT flight, the density of drone operations in the country is going to increase and there is going to be a need to fly in yellow and red zones. The national UTM policy being framed under the Ministry of Civil Aviation is greatly going to help achieve safe and scalable unmanned aircraft system operations in the country.
We are proud to become one of 13 approved consortiums to conduct BVLOS trials in India. These experimentations will enable the use cases such as package delivery, pipeline inspection, precision agriculture.
In the lockdown due to COVID-19, there was a large need to use drones for crowd monitoring as well as public announcements by the government agencies. Ministry of Civil Aviation came up with the Garud portal to fast track the clearances required to operate the same.
Drone Federation of India ke help se 5 drone provide karwaye hain. Ye 5 drone jo hain is pure matrix mein deploy kiye gaye hain. Ek larger picture aur larger view jo hai pure ilake ka jo congested ilaka hai khaskar walled city ka aur uska hamare ko view mil raha hai aur jo bhi koi violation हमें दिख रही है उसको हम एजुकेशन के जरिए जो हम अनाउंसमेंट के थ्रू कर रहे हैं और एनफोर्समेंट के जरिए जो कानूनी कार्रवाई की जा रही है दोनों की हेल्प से हम लोग सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग का भी पालन करवा रहे हैं और जो कोविड-19 की संक्रमण की चेन है उसको तोड़ने में हमारी मदद करेंगे.
Welcome initiatives like Swamitv scheme which enables Survey of India to effectively use drones to map out all the 6.6 lakh villages of the country and ensures issuing of very accurate land record documents to the citizens residing in our villages. And considering the size of the project, I am pretty sure that this will bring a big impetus to the entire drone ecosystem of the country as well.
Patient, because once things get on the track, the entire industry is going to benefit. Initiative taken by Survey of India is going to percolate down to states, from state to districts, and to different government agencies.
Now, this is proven that this technology is here to stay. Number one. Number two, there is no substitute to this. We did one pilot in Maharashtra, the Sonari village. So they used all their conventional methods, whether it's a total station, whether it's GPS or chains, everything they did with all conventional methods, they undertook the measurements and verified that yes, everything is within the permissible limit, what we said. He had said 5 centimeters as the positional accuracy, absolute accuracy, and the 5 centimeters GSD also, the ground sampling distance or resolution, what you call. Now, this was the highest resolution which so far any agency could achieve.
Most recently, the ministry has introduced a lot of energy into the drones ecosystem with the right kind of regulatory intervention. And including efforts right in the middle of the COVID crisis. We've seen the introduction of an overarching regulatory framework, which is currently undergoing public consultation. With this kind of intervention, I see a very bright future for the industry.
We, being the thought leaders in aviation education, it is also our moral responsibility to the nation to impart drone training. Therefore, we are in the process of setting up a flying training school to train young budding pilots to fly drones, meeting our national regulations.
As you know, recently there was a locust attack on Indian agriculture field. We worked very closely with Ministry of Agriculture and Ministry of Civil Aviation to get fast approval for deploying drones for locust control and help our farmers.
India's first petrol-operated hybrid spraying drones, designed by Anna University, particularly designed for locust as well as agricultural application. Thanks for Ministry of Civil Aviation and DGCA for approving this machine for locust operations. Definitely it will meet Indian farmers' requirement. Under Make in India category, it requires nearly about 2 lakh drones are required for India.
And enter into not assembly alone, but design, development and manufacturing of drones.
We realize that the efficiency of this process can be multiplied if the operations were performed during night time. The swarms of locusts, they settle down during night time and we can easily target them. Ministry of Civil Aviation has worked with us to ensure this, and now the operations are being performed day and night.
While other drone warriors are helping the nation with natural calamities, we reached out to the ministry for an industrial use case for inspection of pipeline between Delhi and Panipat for Indian Oil Corporation. We have been given an exemption and we are going to start the work very soon.
Recently, Astidia and Quidditch collaborated to carry out India's first NPNT compliant drone flight. We were able to conclusively demonstrate that the NPNT architecture and Digital Sky platform are fully operational and ready to scale up.
The vast applications of drones are no more a surprise to anyone. Especially in India, the kind of applications that we're seeing are absolutely phenomenal. Drones are being able to impact not just large-scale industry, but even the lives of the poor and disadvantaged. Farmers, miners, construction workers, and now we've seen some great applications in disaster management as well. At the Drone Federation of India, we believe that the future of this industry lies in collaboration, where the industry can work with partners and work with each other to be able to build out world-class products, and the government can work with the industry to be able to build out a regulation that is in the interest of everyone to be able to make sure that India can be the drone hub of the world.
We know the future is bright. The big wave is coming. The big wave could be 6 months, 1 year or 2 years down the line, but the big wave is coming. And that's why we see so many young people and not so young people in this room, all excited. We can feel it in our bones. We have the capability to become the drone hub of the world.
Every decade, technology has bringing in some revolution. And if I may say, the coming decade is going to be revolutionized by drones.
We have the potential to become global leaders in this industry, both in terms of conceptualization, design, manufacture, and operations. Potential we have in terms of engineering, innovation, and entrepreneurship is something that will equip us to do very well.